Hello everyone, my name is Martje from Crafty Quo Designs. I am very excited to be a guest designer for Mama Elephant's 9th year anniversary celebration. One of the stamp sets I have received as guest designer is the Hot Cocoa stamp set. I thought it would be cool to create sort of a stain background for this stamp, so I wanted to have sort of a look of spilled coffee or hot cocoa, so that is what I'm going to do. First, I wet my watercolor cardstock with some water, and now I'm just painting on a bit of the Distress Ink Walnut Stain. I'm also removing a few of the spots with a paper towel, because I do not want to have a perfect watercolor wash. I really wanted to create an irregular look with a lot of spots. And now, before I start working on my second layer, I will first dry the first layer. And for the second layer of the watercoloring, I am using the Distress Ink Vintage Photo. And this time I am not covering up the whole background, but just certain spots. And I also try to make sure that I do not have any even edges. You really don't need any watercolor skills to create a background like this, because it is supposed to be very messy. And to make it look even more messy, I'm also going to add some splatters. First, I tried to add splatters with a smaller paintbrush, but I felt the splatters were not big enough. So for my second try, I'm just going to add splatters with the Distress Ink Walnut Stain and with my big paintbrush, and this created the splatters I was looking for. I really had a lot of fun creating this messy background, and I do feel it looks like a stain of coffee or something. And by the way, the stitching you saw around the edges, that was with a die from the Cloud 9 set from Mama Elephant. As I did watercoloring for the background, I also wanted to do watercoloring for the hot cocoa critters. This way, everything will have the same look and feel. And as I'm going to do watercoloring, I am going to stamp the image with VersaFine Onyx Black ink, which is a waterproof ink. The watercoloring I'm going to do today is going to be quite simple, so you do not need a lot of skill to do it. On the side I have put several Distress Inks that I want to do the watercoloring with, and on screen I will also show each time what colors I am using. Next to the Distress Inks I have also two jars of water. One contains clean water, and the other one is for my dirty brush. The watercolor cardstock I am using today is not of top quality, but I'm also doing quite simple watercoloring, so it was not really required. But you do get better results when you use a top quality watercolor cardstock, like for instance Arches, which is my favorite. In the description box down below, I will list the watercolor cardstock that I used for this card, but I will also list two other watercolor cardstocks that I can really recommend. After this critter, I will also color another critter from the Hot Cocoa set, but for the rest of the watercoloring, I will put up some music, so you can enjoy the music and watch me color. Enjoy! Alright, that was all the watercoloring, so now we can get started on the rest of the card. Off camera, I have die-cut the Big Warm Fuzzy Hugs from Nina Desert Storm cardstock and Speckled Egg cardstock from Lanfan. I'm going to adhere these two on top of each other, but I'm going to offset it a bit. So the Nina Desert Storm cardstock will provide sort of a shadow layer. For that reason, I'm only putting liquid glue on the right-hand side of the letters, because the left-hand side will be exposed. And then when I put my speckled egg cardstock on top, I am making sure that it will be offset a little bit. And because I'm adhering it with liquid glue, I also have some wiggle room, so I can make sure that you see the Desert Storm cardstock everywhere peeking through. The Warm Fuzzy Hugs is only the first part of the sentiment. I wanted there to be a second part. So I'm going to use one of the sentiments from the Hot Cocoa stamp set, but I only wanted to use a part of it. So that is why I'm now masking it off with the purple tape, and then before I stamp it, I will first remove the purple tape. And this way I am only stamping the In a Mug, and I chose the Stress Oxide Vintage Photo to stamp with. Off camera, I stamped it one more time to get a good impression. Then here we have all the elements for the card. I will first start by adhering the Warm Fuzzy Hugs sentiment. Before I really put it down, I'm also checking with one of the critters if I like the position of the sentiment, because I still want to have enough room at the bottom for those two critters. Then for adhering the Hot Cocoa critters, I'm going to use foam squares from Scrapbook Adhesives, and I'm going to use the thin ones and also the regular ones. For the right-hand critter, I decided to use the thin ones, so that will be more in the back. And then for the left one, I am using the regular foam squares, so it will be popped up more. For the sentiment, I will be using the regular foam squares as well, so it really stands out. And that finishes off this card. I really hope you liked this card and you enjoyed watching this video. Remember to like and subscribe if you did. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.